Hey, what's up? I'm Myles.
And I'm Shirin.
And we're the host of Above the Noise, a show that cuts through the hype
and digs into the science behind the headlines.
In last week's episode, we talked about marijuana and why it's so hard to get medical research done on it. So marijuana is in a weird catch-22. The federal government still classifies it as a potentially dangerous drug with zero medical benefits. But research keeps emerging that tells a different story. So some states are bypassing federal law so patients can access it anyway. Basically, the states are betting that the benefits of weed are going to outweigh the risk. So one thing that I thought was pretty tight about working on this episode was how it's a great example of how policy can affect science and research. You know, doing the episode, you find out that there's literally all these hoops and things you have to jump through. All these acronyms, FDA, NIDA, and all these things that I can't remember off the top of my head. But anyway.
Well, we had some great comments on this topic. So our first one is from a commenter who said, "I think that the federal government should legalize medical marijuana. It would help relieve the pain of patients with chronic illnesses, especially cancer. And the side effects, in my opinion, are better than that of alternative drugs." So Myles, what do you think about that?
That's really valid. It reminds me of the opioid crisis. So you have these people that are prescribed painkillers to, you know, obviously reduce pain in their body, but what happens is they get highly addicted. And also, you know, in addition to that, they say that people who are on opioids are more likely to start using heroin because, you know, similar effects. And it's become like this huge problem across the United States of America. But what doctors are starting to look at now is marijuana as an alternative because, you know, it does a lot of the same things. It relieves pain in the body and reduces that pain.
Yeah, that's a great point. So another question from Raquel, who asks, "Why was marijuana, which has been used recreationally and for health purposes throughout history, outlawed in the first place? Didn't it have something to do with race? Wasn't it used as a justification by the federal government to target African Americans?" She wants to learn more about the history of marijuana.
Okay.
So enlighten us, please.
So, you know, buckle up, everybody. Nah, but there's a lot that was mentioned in that, and there's a lot of ways that you can take it. So one thing to look at that I thought was interesting was I was looking up this man whose name was Harry Anslinger, and he was basically in charge of the Department of Prohibition. And, you know, so that was the outlaw of alcohol back in, what, the 30s? So he basically lost that battle, obviously, because they legalized alcohol. You know, the streets were running crazy with the, you know, criminals taking over whole neighborhoods and whatnot. So his department was like, okay, what do? We don't have a drug to, you know, get people on anymore. And up until that point, marijuana wasn't that big a deal to him, but he saw an opportunity. He was like, yo, marijuana, it makes you crazy. It drives you mad. It drives you to the point of insanity where you won't come back. I mean, some of you may have heard the term reefer madness, mm-hmm. or even seen the movie where the guy just goes insane, and it was like such a bad movie that it was basically a comedy, basically like that. So that's a little piece of history about how marijuana became like illegal in a sense. But then also you look at like the war on drugs and how it disproportionately affects people of color. Like you mentioned, African Americans are targeted. So I actually looked into this, and the ACLU had some great information for me. Even though the uses of it are equal between black and whites, blacks are 4 times more likely to be arrested for it. So, you know, you have all these things that kind of just culminate over time and disproportionately affect African Americans.
Nearly 4 times as likely, that's it.
That's
a big disparity.
That, yeah, when you hear that, it really puts it into perspective. The last comment that we'll read today was, "Why is it that federal law is able to be overridden by state law, especially on such a possibly dangerous subject?"
All right, so here's how it works. It's a little bit complicated, but essentially there's 2 separate legal systems. There's a federal system and the states. And now, even if medical marijuana is okay in your state, if the federal government comes knocking at your door, you can get in trouble with the federal legal system. And that can have some pretty big repercussions. I mean, you can go to federal prison. Now, in the past, with the Obama administration, there had essentially been an agreement between the federal government and local governments where the federal government wouldn't go after mm-hmm. people who were using medical marijuana. But with this current administration, yeah. Who knows? Up in there.
Yeah, who knows? So that is our episode for today, guys. If you guys have any ideas, suggestions, pitches, let us know. Put them in the comments section. We'll read them. You know, hopefully we can have more engaging conversations like this. And till then, I'm Myles.
I'm Shirin.
This is the show that cuts through the hype
and takes you above the noise.